Quite frankly, as a driver that's been with Lyft for nearly 5 years now, I was getting sick of the fact that I still needed to complete a certain amount of peak rides and maintain a 90% acceptance rate for the week in order to attain the power driver bonus. So I was really happy to hear that the power driver bonus was being replaced by the weekly ride challenge. Joe here with the Rideshare Guy, and today we are going to recap my first month of driving with the weekly ride challenge. So with the weekly ride challenge, you no longer need to complete a certain amount of peak rides for the week or maintain a 90% acceptance rate. You just have to complete a certain amount of rides for the week. It's only based on the amount of rides that you complete. And the weekly ride challenge should now be live in all markets. Lyft officially ended the power driver bonus at the end of last month. And also with the weekly ride challenge, you're basically given your requirements every single week, as opposed to the power driver bonus, which those requirements would change only a few times throughout the year. And the weekly ride challenge bonus is based on your driving, how you drive. So previously with the power driver bonus, my requirements, I used to have four different tiers that I could qualify for. I would always qualify for the minimum tier, which was 45 rides, 30 peak rides for a $60 bonus. So based on how I have driven, that is how Lyft has determined my weekly ride challenge amounts for the first month here. And here's a look at the amounts that I've been offered for my first 4 weeks of driving with the weekly ride challenge. My first week I was offered two tiers. I've been offered two tiers every single week. So it's 50 rides or 60 rides. My first week it was 50 rides for $69, 60 for 107. That 60 for 107 has stayed consistent throughout the 4 weeks. Week two, it was 50 rides for $79. Week three, 50 for 60. And then week four, 50 for $69 again. And in each week, I've attained the minimum 50 ride bonus. And again, these amounts are compared to the 45 ride, $60 PDB tier that I consistently qualified for. And so far with the weekly ride challenge, I am earning a little bit more per ride, about $1.38 extra per ride compared to $1.33 extra per ride under the power driver bonus. It's only about a 4% increase, but any increase in pay is a positive thing, I think. As far as my overall thoughts so far, I love not needing to worry about those peak rides and maintaining that 90% acceptance rate anymore. It gives me a lot more flexibility with my driving. For instance, I no longer need to accept that last peak ride at say 8:59 a.m. And then have that ride take me to the airport when I just want to go home for the day. And this helps Lyft too. Under the power driver bonus, when peak hours were from let's say 4 in the afternoon to 6 at night, I would typically drive till about 3:30 and then log out. And I would log out because I didn't want to get a ride at that time that would take me into the peak hour. This way I'm driving more, I'm not logging out for that purpose. And since there are no longer peak rides included in the weekly ride challenge, I don't have to worry about that anymore. And also since there's no longer a 90% acceptance rate requirement, I no longer need to worry about declining those requests that are 15 plus minutes away during the morning and evening rush hours. It happens a lot here in Minnesota, especially when you're not just downtown. You'll get requests that are 15, 20, 25 minutes away sometimes. With the weekly ride challenge, I can just decline those right away. I don't have to worry about maintaining that 90% acceptance rate anymore. And also under the power driver bonus, I was always scrambling. Towards the end of the week, I was always scrambling for peak rides. And so I would have to make sure that I could drive, you know, evening Fridays or in the evening on Saturdays. Now if I am at the end of the week with the weekly ride challenge bonus, and I need more rides, I don't have to worry about driving during those times. I can pick any time. I could drive on Saturday during the day or even Sunday if I needed more rides. And one major issue I do have is sometimes when I log in the morning, during the morning rush, I will get requests that are 15, 20 minutes away, and this will happen like four or five times in a row. And I'll snap deny all those requests. And even though there are no longer acceptance rate requirements, your acceptance rate is still being calculated. And this could be a relic of the system. It could be something that Lyft is trying to change eventually here. They're probably in the process of changing this, hopefully. But I'm getting texts, I'm getting emails saying that my acceptance rate is low. Routing of rides in general is something that I think Lyft especially needs to work on, at least definitely in the Minneapolis and St. Paul market. There's gotta be a better way to route these rides. We shouldn't be receiving these 15, 20 plus minute requests. And this is definitely a topic that I'm gonna go into further detail in a future video. But for those of you that have been driving with the weekly ride challenge for a while now, let us know how it's worked out for you. If it's given you more flexibility, how you like it compared to the power driver bonus. Have you been offered good amounts? Are you being offered this similar amounts to the power driver bonus amounts that you were offered previously? Again, if you haven't subscribed to the Rideshare Guy channel, please subscribe. We post new videos, multiple new videos every single week. Thanks again for watching, and drive safe. Thanks.